Have you ever paused to think about how an AI model can read a chunky paragraph and answer you in perfect sentences? That mystery begins with something tiny, tokens. So today, let's look into how these bite-sized bits of text power the smartest chatbots and language tools on the planet. I'm Sissy with JotForm, and in this video, we'll explore what tokens are, why tokenization matters, and how different token strategies help AI keep up with everything from slang to code snippets. We'll also look at the role tokens play inside models like GPT and BERT. Plus, a quick peek at where tokenization is headed next. Let's jump right in. A token is the smallest chunk of text that an AI model treats as meaningful. Depending on the approach, a token might be the whole word, a syllable, or a single character. By slicing text into these manageable units, AI systems replace the messy fluidity of natural language with Lego-style pieces that fit together in predictable ways. That slicing happens through tokenization, the behind-the-scenes procedure that splits sentences and paragraphs into tokens. When a language model tokenizes, it marks boundaries, often at spaces or punctuation, and hands each resulting piece to the neural network. Because language brims with nuance, tokenization gives AI a tidier job, letting it spot patterns, extract meaning, and craft fluent replies without drowning in complexity. Think of tokens as the puzzle pieces that form every page you read. Whether a piece is an entire word, a familiar prefix, or even just a punctuation mark, each token gets converted into numbers. Those numbers represent where the token sits in semantic space, and once they flow through a network's layers, the model predicts what should come next or figures out how the current chunk relates to the wider conversation. Take the sentence, "I love JotForm." A straightforward word-based system might treat that as three tokens, I, love, and JotForm. Break it further into subwords and you might carve JotForm into smaller segments. Either way, every token gets translated into a vector, and the model works with vectors to generate a response that sounds like it understands your enthusiasm. So how exactly does the breakdown work? Tokenization starts by identifying edges, often white space, punctuation, or changes in character type, and slicing text into a lineup of tokens. Once that sequence is set, the model transforms each token into a numerical vector that encodes meaning or grammar. Those vectors flow through dense layers and all the other architecture you hear about in transformer models. The net effect? The AI recognizes patterns, predicts the next word, classifies the topic, or performs whatever language trick you need. Now, there isn't just one way to tokenize. Different goals call for different methods, and each method brings trade-offs. First up is word tokenization. This straightforward approach splits text at spaces and punctuation, giving every word its own token. It works well with languages like English that rely on spaces, but it struggles with languages where words blend together. And if you try to cover an entire dictionary this way, your vocabulary balloons fast, making the model hefty. Next up is subword tokenization, which is a favorite in models like GPT and BERT. Instead of treating every full word as a unique token, subword schemes split words into common roots and affixes. That means the root predict and endings such as ed or ing can reassemble into dozens of variations without inflating vocabulary. Tools like WordPiece or SentencePiece learn the best breakpoints by scanning huge text corpora and tracking frequency. Character tokenization goes even smaller. Here, each character is a token. The good news, you'll never run into an unknown symbol because every letter and punctuation mark already lives in the set. The not so good news, sequences get very long, slowing training. Still, for languages with complex morphology or tests where tiny character changes carry weight, say gene sequences, character tokenization shines. Byte pair encoding, often shortened to BPE, finds a middle ground by merging the most frequent pairs of characters or subwords again and again until it lands on an efficient set of tokens. BPE packs text into compact sequences, yet stays flexible enough to handle rare or made-up words. That balance between vocabulary size and performance explains why it's now a staple in many transformer-based NLP systems. Why not simply hand an entire word list to the model and call it a day? For one thing, English alone boasts roughly 171,000 current use words, and that number explodes when you factor in technical jargon, slang, or other languages. Tokens trim that sprawl by reusing subwords or characters. Even better, tokens help with out-of-vocabulary words. If the model hasn't seen hyper-automation before, subword tokenization can break it into parts it already knows, so meaning isn't lost and the system stays resilient. Inside today's most common models, tokens run the show. OpenAI's GPT series converts every prompt into tokens, maps each token to an embedding vector, then threads those vectors through the transformer layers that gather context from neighbors. Thanks to tokens, GPT can juggle words, subwords, punctuation marks, and emojis without missing a beat. GPT-4, for example, can manage more than 8,000 tokens in a single pass, though cranking the limit upward will cost extra compute. Feed it more than its limit, and it will trim or drop the excess. BERT relies on WordPiece, its own subword toolkit. BERT encodes tokens bidirectionally, reading context from both left and right, which helps it excel at classification and question-answer tasks. Like GPT, BERT has token limits. Once you exceed them, information gets clipped. Tokenization is also growing beyond plain text. Multimodal AI looks at images, audio, and other data types, assigning each component a token-like representation. One unified model could caption photos, discuss a soundtrack, and answer text questions simply by juggling different kinds of tokens. Remarkably powerful once token management matures. For teams building chatbots, document classifiers, or content generators, grasping how tokens work can streamline pipelines and save on compute. Choose the right tokenization strategy and you'll get faster processing, better coverage of unusual terms, and models that scale gracefully. If you'd like to see tokenizers in action, OpenAI's tokenizer documentation and the Hugging Face Transformers library both provide hands-on tools and examples, showing exactly how your text becomes numbers under the hood. Thank you so much for watching today. I'm Sissy with JotForm, and if you enjoyed learning about AI tokens, click that subscribe button so you never miss a future deep dive. Take care, and I'll see you next time.